Oklahoma, Gypsy, The King and I, Fiddler on the Roof, West Side Story. There are only a handful of musicals that are timeless, classic masterpieces. Now there is a brilliant new show that you can add to that list. Ladies and gentlemen, Ragtime.
House at the crest of the Broadview Avenue Hill in New Rochelle, New York. And it seemed for some years thereafter that all the family's days would be warm and fair.
The skies were blue and hazy, barely a storm, barely a chill. And there was distant music, simple and somehow sublime, giving the nation a new syncopation. The people called it ragtime.
Father was well off, very well off. His considerable income was derived from the manufacture of fireworks and bunting and other accoutrements of patriotism. Father was also something of an amateur explorer.
The house on the hill in New Rochelle was Mother's domain. She took pleasure in making it comfortable for the men of her family and often told herself how fortunate she was to be so protected and provided for by her husband.
Tennis balls.
There were gazebos and there were no Negroes.
And everything was ragtime.
In Harlem, men and women of color forgot their troubles and danced and reveled to the music of Cole House Walker Jr. This was a music that was theirs and no one else's.
One young woman thought Cole House played just for her. Her name was Sarah.
Ladies with parasols, fellows with tennis balls. There were no Negroes and there were no immigrants.
In Latvia, a man dreamed of a new life for his little girl. It would be a long journey, a terrible one. He would not lose her as he had her mother. His name was Tata. He never spoke of his wife. The little girl was all he had now. Together, they would escape.